Fair use allows to distribute, reproduce, and show clips for criticism, commenting, reporting, teaching, and research of copyrighted material without authorization of the copyright holder.
Hey brothers and sisters, it's Jared. As I work on this End Times Parenting series, the Lord has been revealing more and more to me how our children are under attack. From teachings in the school, to peer pressure with friends, and indoctrinating programming with the satanic media. We're going to be taking a look at Cartoon Network and how it is being used to indoctrinate children to the signs, symbols, and ideals of the satanic cults. The first show we are going to look at is Mr. Pickles, which recently premiered on Adult Swim. Now, Adult Swim says that it is for adults, but the reality is it is on a children's channel, and kids watch this show as well. And even if it is for adults, the level of satanic filth in this show, no one should want to watch. And what is worse is the subliminal satanic messages they flash on the screen for an instant that assault your subconscious. Brothers and sisters, it's lame. And the season promo openly told the audience they are indoctrinating them and told them to sell their souls while flashing images of Baphomet.
Now, it's kind of hard to see, but they do these little quick flashes, and this image pops up. Right here, you have the pentagram 666 and saying good boy. Then it zooms into the dog and you can see this happen. We had to slow this down a lot so you can actually see it. Here, I'll do it again. It goes in, the pentagram. Shows you the 666, the skull. Upside down cross with the pentagram in the middle saying good boy again. Pyramid, all seeing eye. Throughout the cartoons, you'll see a lot of parts where you're listening and then you hear him speaking like the satanic voice. So what I did is I will play the clip of him scrambled, and then what I did is I flipped the audio so you can actually hear what it is he's saying.
Beauty is beyond words. I must have you.
It's hard to make out, but he says, beauty is not important. I must have you. So as you can see clearly right here, Mr. Pickle is sitting on top of a throne. You've got a pentagram here. You've got one here. It looks like it's written in blood. You've got this sexual slave type thing, torture devices, a severed goat head with horns on top of this lady waving the leaf, trying to treat him like he's a king. All right, so here's the beginning. It says, since 1425, one secret organization, then it flashes over to the next set of text, has sought dominion over the world of man. And then really quick, you get this flash. It says Illuminati. You've got to slow down the footage to see that. Then it goes, tonight it reaches a new level of indoctrination. And then you get a flash that says, hell, Baphomet. Really quick, once again, naked eye can't see it. We've got to slow it down for you to be able to see it. Then it says, with an animated show about a dog, give your soul to Mr. Pickles. And then it flashes a picture, an old school symbol of Baphomet. Then you get a flash of a pentagram. And that happens a couple times back and forth over the give your soul to Mr. Pickles image.
Now, for those of you saying this is about a satanic dog, of course it's going to have that. You were missing the point. Please let me explain to you what is going on. If you disagree with me, that's fine. The satanic cults know they are unacceptable to the general public, so they are using the tactic of subliminal propaganda to shift the public opinion. Whereas 50 years ago, shows like this would have been picketed, they are now accepted because of gradual desensitization to evil through our medias. Now, why would Cartoon Network do this? The Bible warns us in 1 John 5:19, we know we are of God, and the whole world lieth in wickedness. Cartoon Network is of this world, one of the pinnacles of children's entertainment, and we are going to take a look at how they are doing this. The first thing you need to know is Cartoon Network's logo is spelled out in the black and white checkerboard fashion. The occult believe in non-dualism, the necessity of good and evil, and the harnessing of both of these spiritual elements. This is why you will constantly see this imagery promoted in the Illuminati-controlled entertainment industry. Then Cartoon Network affirms this symbolism by incorporating the all-seeing eye in their television ads and bumpers, with the black and white non-duality checkerboard pattern and the all-seeing eye. This is like the kid version of their occult symbolism. The Illuminati eye is symbolic of the light bearer, Satan, Lucifer, their Antichrist Messiah. Now, this is just the logo and TV spots. In the shows and animated series is where the real symbolic reinforcement and satanic ideals are projected at our children. Now, we are going to look at a couple ways they are doing this. And remember, they do this under the guise of innocence. They cover their satanic rituals with cartoons, so it is not as offensive or obvious. But it is the same wicked satanic arts and promotes and fosters the same Antichrist spirit in our children. Now, if we look at satanic worshippers and cults, we'll see that one of their practices is the robed ceremonies for sacrifice or other satanic rituals. These ceremonies are often used to enlighten and understudy to the ancient secret knowledge of the occult. And that is exactly what they are introducing our children to in these television shows. They portray these robe ceremonies to children, introducing them to the occult at a young age. In SpongeBob SquarePants, a really popular TV show for kids, they blatantly portray the Illuminati pyramid with the eye of Lucifer. Inside the pyramid, they are having a robe ceremony, like the practicers of the occult. Now, these occultists believe that Satan, Lucifer, is the light bearer. They live by the Gnostic belief that the serpent in the garden was good. They believe that he enlightened Eve by giving her the forbidden fruit. So, in this ceremony in the SpongeBob SquarePants show, the initiates get enlightened by the serpent in the cage by receiving a mark on their forehead. This is symbolic of the mark of the beast. Now, they introduce our children to ceremonies like these when they are young, so they are desensitized and prepared for the Adult Swim versions, like in Lucy, Daughter of the Devil. Now, that name should already give you a warning that this is satanic. And in this show, they have satanic rituals with human sacrifice.
Sacrifice, the most monstrous of all satanic rituals.
Raise Satan!
And reenactments of actual satanic rituals, like at Bohemian Grove, where the satanic hierarchy perform a sacrifice and burn a giant idol in the image of an owl in the ceremony called the Cremation of Care in Bohemian Grove, California. Now, beyond these ceremonies, you will see that Adult Swim constantly uses the owl symbolism in their bumpers, often with creepy messages like, "Do not stray," or "Watching is better than living." Now, these statements should not sit well with anyone, and we must understand, as soldiers in this battle, we fight not against flesh and blood, but spirits and principalities. The reason these occultists are placing symbols on television is because the TV is our society's most worshipped idol. And by putting their imagery in shows we enjoy, they divert praise and energy to their satanic system. Countless children's shows are promoting this occult symbolism. The Illuminati pyramid is constantly presented to our children in their entertainment, representing this Antichrist system. It is late, brothers and sisters, and the symbolism is obvious. But the last thing I am going to look at is the subliminal messages and pyramid praise. The subliminal messages are on the shows and masked to the conscious mind, but picked up by the subconscious. This is spiritual warfare on our minds. Satan is a manipulator. Adventure Time, a show targeted at children on Cartoon Network Primetime, is notorious of this. Like in scenes where for a split second, demonic images are flashed on the screen for a frame. A demon is crowned in this scene on a throne in our children's subconscious. Now, the pyramid hand sign is also done both subliminally and blatantly. The satanic cults use this sign to worship the Antichrist system, and they are deceiving the world into worshiping the system by having their puppets promoted to their fans and followers. Jay-Z, a student of the mystery schools, promotes it to his fans, and by the thousands, they raise their hands in worship. Barack Obama also promoted it during his campaign under the cover of the letter O. But as you see, the people who are throwing it up are also doing the same pyramid hand sign. In Steven Universe, another Cartoon Network primetime show for kids, they flash this symbol for a brief second while doing magic. Other children's shows use this symbol and relate it to our kids as the same robed occult ceremonies. And we have to understand that this hand sign is a promotion of the Antichrist. That's why in music videos, like from I Am Legion, you'll see them throwing up the hand sign in the darkness, and then it will fade to the person on the throne. This is symbolic of the Antichrist that they are worshiping, the one that is to come. Now, this is the most disturbing thing I saw involving these hand signs. This is a show that played on Saturday morning cartoons. It's called Symbiotic Titan, and it relates the pyramid to sexual immorality and lust.
The isosceles triangle has two congruent sides.
Made the satanic agenda and programming of Cartoon Network clear in this hour. This is sick, putting a spirit of lust and sexual submission in our children. The scripture tells us that the world lieth in wickedness, but in our society we are running further and further from God. So even in the professing church, people are not discerning and are subjecting their children to this programming and preparing them for the Antichrist system. The Bible tells us to lead our children in the fear and admonition of the Lord. We cannot lead them in that while programming them to the Antichrist system. Scripture warns us in 1 John 2:15-17, love not the world, neither the things that are in the world. If any man love the world, the love of the Father is not in him. For all that is in the world, the lust of the flesh, the lust of the eyes, and the pride of life, is not of the Father, but is of the world. And the world passeth away, and the lust thereof. But he that doeth the will of God will abideth forever. You see, the huge problem that we face, the big foe that we fight, is not the Illuminati or satanic cults or anything like that. It is simply this world. It's this world's ideals. It's this world's belief system. This world hates God. This world crucified Christ. And when it is trying to conform us and we give in to that conforming, we are against Christ. It says, whoever loves the world or the things in this world, the love of the Father is not in him. If you don't have the love of the Father in you, you're not going to be able to stand up against this foe. You're not going to be able to battle these demons. You see, part of the problem is even our flippant language. You notice how, like, we'll say, oh man, I love that restaurant, or I love that show, or I love that movie. Why do we talk like that? It's in direct opposition to what our Lord told us. It's in direct opposition to what His holy scriptures teach. So when we say things like that, we're putting the world in a high place. We're putting it at an altar. If you get nothing else from this video, I pray that you see that this world is completely against Christ. Even the stuff that it says is innocent is against God. And when we let our children watch these things that are against God, begin to enjoy these things that are against God, it is detrimental to their spiritual walk with the Lord. It's not going to make them run out and go crazy. I'm not saying that at all. But the effects you don't even see on the surface level. It's in the spiritual realm. It's putting them into bondage in the spiritual realm. I know this. I was addicted to TV shows. I grew up on cartoons. And the effects of that could be seen throughout my adult life. It took the Holy Spirit of God to free me. You don't want to put that burden on your child. We are called to be stewards in this hour, to lead them in righteousness and truth, not let the world have its programming and way with them, especially the satanic programming that's being projected to them right now. And I will encourage you in this, that if you are a parent who is letting your kid watch television without previewing or watching with them, then that's not a good idea in this hour. It is a satanic culture we're in. Whatever they say is good is against God. It says, whatever's highly esteemed among men is an abomination to God. So we have to understand this. If you do not let your kids watch TV without knowing what they are watching, you just cannot do it in this hour. It's not a discerning thing to do. And if you don't have kids, or if you're a young person who's still living with your parents, I'm speaking to you in this too. Let us live a life for God. Do you really want to sit down in front of this satanic filth that is against your Lord? It is not eternally beneficial. It is spiritual attacks against you. It will weaken you against all that the enemy throws your way. Your discernment will go down. Your sensitivity to the will of the Lord will go down. Your reading of His Holy Word, your strength in Him will all be on attack. Just because of the idols that we build up in our life, the high places we put in our life. And we need to understand this. The child of God loves the Lord. He does not watch filth that is against God. It will make you sick because you love Christ. And when we come into Christ, we become new creatures with new desires. Old things pass away and behold, new things come. What you used to love, you now hate. And what you hated, you now love. So I just want to encourage you guys in that. I stand with Joshua in this. If Baal is God, serve him. If Netflix is God, bow down there. If cable television is God, serve that. But if God is God, serve him. And as for me and my house, we will serve the Lord. Jesus Christ came to defeat this system. He came to free us from the shackles that Satan is putting on the human race. We are born anew in him, and I will raise my daughter up in the fear and admonition of the Lord. I encourage you guys, I exhort you guys, this is the time that we count the cost, that we look onto the blessed hope of the coming of our Lord and eternal glory in him, and stop selling out for the short trifles of this world and the false promises and satanic lies that it has for us. God bless you guys. Stay strong in him, stay in prayer, and stay in the word. This is the hour we were called for. We are the remnant, and we will boast on the holy name of Christ in this dark hour.